Although the pressure is on for Puna voters, some of them told us voting is the last thing on their minds as they continue to clean up after Tropical Storm Iselle. Today, the governor went to the Big Island to tour the damage. Nestor Garcia is there on the ground with the latest.
The governor showed up at the Nana Valley Community Association late this Wednesday afternoon after he saw for himself the destruction out here in this area. There are some 600 homes and some 1,400 residents who live in Nana Valley Estates. And we were told that there are about 10 homes that they were completely destroyed. I saw for myself at least one of those homes, and at that one home, I was told that a family actually rode out the storm in a room at the back of the house. And fortunately, even though trees fell on that home on Holiday Street, no one was injured. And the governor also said when he talked to reporters that he has begun the application to ask the president to consider whether to declare this area a disaster.
I'm going to file the right application because, as you know, there's a couple more storms, possibly even more, developing out there. We don't know the degree and the extent to which they may develop into from tropical storms, possibly into hurricanes. I don't want to get in a situation where FEMA loses any kind of we lose credibility with FEMA by not zeroing in on exactly what we need to do.
After he left the Nana Valley Community Association, the governor was quick to thank the guardsmen and the people out here who are volunteering at the Nana Valley Community Association for distributing ice and bottled water to the victims of the storm. And the governor says that he is very thankful for everyone, including the nonprofits who are coming together to help the people out here in Puna. This is Nestor Garcia reporting live from the Nana Valley Community Association in Puna.